Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be reviewing Sun Going Down by Jack Tor. If you like action, if you like romance, if you like adventure, then this is a book for you. The Sun Going Down is quite a lengthy book, and indeed it is so because it spans over four generations of a family. It is loosely based on the lives of the author's relatives. So the plot line of the story starts from the Civil War and it ends till the Depression era. So everything that happened in the American history is narrated by the and we come to know how each aspect of the history affected the family in question. The characterization is quite brilliant. Each character is sketched out perfectly. So even though there are too many characters in this book, we know which character the author is talking about. There is no confusion. Even it is seen that in the stories of these era, especially in the American West, the female characters are not crafted well. Not in this book. In this book, the female characters are extremely spunky. They have their own characters. I especially like the character of a female that comes in the second generation. The narration is such that we feel that the author paints the canvas of the environment along with the characters, so we know exactly what the characters are feeling and what they are looking at. One thing to keep in mind though, that the English used is quite hard, especially for those who are not familiar with the Western English. So initially it takes a couple of pages, at least the 10 to 15 pages, to be acquainted with the language, and from then on the reading process becomes quite easier. So if you are having, so if you pick this up and if you are having trouble, I encourage you to plow through and try to understand what the author is trying to say in the initial pages, and I assure you it will be worth it. So the basic storyline starts with Ebenezer Pent, who is a sailor who has a ship and is going through the Mississippi River. He sees that there are that due to the current political climate, it is becoming quite difficult to carry on the trade, and so he sells off his ship and tries to make it on the land. Here he meets a lady and falls in love, and they get married, and then they have twins. The story Ebenezer is a kind of a wayward soul. He likes going out in search of fortune and tries to make it big in life. And it is this that quality of his personality that leads to the twins becoming orphans at the age of 15. They then decide to leave everything that their parents have created, and they walk off in search of their own lives. The story then moves on to the twins' struggles in trying to establish their name, their fame, and basically try to understand what they want in life. They are together. Since they are together and still they have very different personalities, it is interesting to note how each brother reacts to the same stimuli. And then basically they try to understand how how their decision would react, would reflect on the other. Then they kind of decide to change ways, since one brother decides to get married and he wants a ranch and wants to settle down, and the other person is not really that ready. He's just like his father, wants to go out into the world and keep on exploring. The story then continues with the first brother's, and he has four daughters and a son. He insists on raising his daughters like sons, so he teaches them everything about the ranch, how to work, and he expects his daughters to give in as many hours of work that he would expect from a son. So that's why his daughters become quite headstrong and they have very strong personalities. The story then goes on with his daughter, his second daughter, who becomes pregnant at the age of 16, and that is why his father kind of banishes her, along with she forces her to get married and then banishes her. And the story then continues on the how this daughter when she was born, her father had acquired quite a land and was quite rich. So So now how she handles herself, her baby, and a kind of a good for nothing husband, and how she tries to make it in her life. So it's quite a huge story, but really interesting. It feels especially for somebody who is not in America, it's really good to know history of the other country while keeping it interesting. So really kudos to author for that. I really recommend this book to anybody who likes a good entertainer and pretty much a story that has a lot of cowboys, a lot of action, and a little bit of romance. So I hope you like this book. Have you read this book or any book of the genre? Would you like me to check out some books? Please let me know in the comments down below. I would love to hear from you, and I'll see you soon.